Pisces, I am your astrologer, Wonder Girl, taking you to new heights. Here's your weekly forecast for the week of Monday, October 23rd to Monday, October 30th, 2017. Now, what's going on this week, Pisces, is that we've got the Sun and Jupiter conjunct right over here in your ninth house of something new and different and exciting that you haven't done before, okay? So what I think you're trying to do here is you're really trying to bring something new and exciting into your life. I wanna say that is very close to your heart in some way. I think that's a big thing. I think maybe it's been hard for you lately, maybe in the past few months or maybe even years, to do something new that you wanted to refresh yourself, to embark on some new journey here. And I think you're finally trying to do that, to step into some new chapters and maybe having to overcome too some uncomfortable feelings that you have from the past about this new thing that it is that you're doing, so that you really can move wholeheartedly into it, okay? I think that is what is going on this week. It could be a little bit difficult because we do have the Sun and Jupiter conjunct there at the very beginning degrees of Scorpio, but this is the ninth house, Pisces. The ninth house is a very good, it's a very happy house for you, so I don't think it'll be, even though if there may be some difficult things, I don't really think it'll be as hard for you as it will be for other people to get on board with this thing, okay? So I think that's what's going on there. Not only are you trying to work some emotional things out in regards to something new and exciting that you're doing so that you can really get on board with it, okay? I also think there's lots of thought and lots of communication too about something new that it is that you're doing as well, with Mercury hanging out nearby, okay? Thinking inside of yourself, of how you can get right with yourself, and communicating too with other people. I think a lot of this communication here has to do where Neptune is in your first house, okay? Right here, something very, very close to your identity and who it is that you are, with Mercury here in your ninth house making a trine to Neptune. Okay, so there's something new going on here in your life that's very important to you and your identity. Okay, taking your identity in new and different directions, and you're trying to get insights on all of that stuff. Okay, because this is Neptune, I actually think you'll have a pretty good time, an easy time, and Neptune is your ruler. I think you'll have a pretty good and easy time of working out this new thing, of getting on board with it and your identity and moving forward on it. But it could bring some confusion as well, just to kind of give you all of the perspective on this, it could bring some confusion as well in regards to your identity, in regards to who you are, okay? Needing to let yourself explore and take on a new identity and be a new person, okay? In order to move forward doing something new and exciting, okay? And if you're trying to fit your identity in a box and be this person in this way and only do these things, and this is the person you've always been, it's gonna be really hard for you to move forward. But if you realize you can be a lot of different things, and you've got a lot of different talents and skills and things about you, it's going to be a lot easier for you to do something new, okay? Now, I say that tentatively because you are a Pisces. Neptune is your ruler. You are very good at dealing with things that are uncertain and things that are unknown, okay, and adapting to these situations. So I think you're going to be fine, okay, moving into these new chapters and reconceptualizing your identity to make room for this new thing. But I just wanted to offer you that perspective in case you do happen to have some difficulty doing these kind of things, okay? So that's what I've got there. I think if you can do these new things and move into these new chapters, it's gonna help you here where Pluto is to reach some new goals and some new dreams and to envision a totally new future for yourself that you feel like is better and will allow you to be more authentically yourself and open up some new doors for you here with Mercury in your ninth, making a sextile to Pluto in your 11th, okay? So I think, so that's what I see going on here. I think there could be some hurt feelings when it comes to where Saturn is in your 10th house of career here, making a square to Chiron in your first. So maybe just worry that your life is not going in the direction that you wanted it to go in, or that it's hard for you to work with your career to make sense of something new and bring something new into your life, or as you're bringing something new, having to change your life direction, maybe some uncomfortable feelings coming from there, but realizing that's, you'll be fine, okay? Not to worry so much about your career. I think what you need to focus on right now, doing something new, doing something exciting to help you reach your goals. And if you do that, it's gonna help a lot of these other things fall into place, okay? One of the things that's gonna help fall into place is right here where the North Node is in Leo. All right, and that's in your sixth house of your job and of your daily routines, with the North Node making a square to Mercury in your ninth. So also focusing on something new and exciting that you haven't done before is also going to help you eventually, even though it may be a little bit of require some effort here, to get your job in order, your daily routines in order, to have a better external existence, okay? And to do things just better on the day to day here. But really all of it having to do a lot with something new that you're doing that you haven't done before in order to work all the other stuff out, okay? So that's what I think is going on for you as you're trying to do that. Some stuff going on here with Venus, which is still in your eighth house of changes happening, going on, and Venus here making a square over to Pluto in your 11th house of goals. So having to change your the way you thought your life was gonna go, envisioning your life. You're having to envision your life different, okay? In a lot of different ways here, and I think you know that, and I think you're trying to work intimately and deeply with other people to change your life and to move your life in some different directions, and really just trying to get on board with that and make sense of how your life is changing and some ending and beginnings that you're making, and some relationship, deep intimate relationship chapters are coming in here. Okay, so I think you're also trying to work out all of that so that you can make room for this new thing here and envision a new future for yourself and just move forward on it in a way that's just better and more exciting. All right, I don't think that's new for you. When it comes to making some changes in your life, or working deeply and intimately with other people and allowing yourself to be vulnerable, all right, I think that's a thing that's been going on for at least a few weeks with a bunch of planets here coming through Libra in the past few weeks, but I think there's still a few more things that you need to work out, still a few more changes that perhaps you need to make in regards to your life, in regards to the direction that it's going in and the person that it is that you thought you were, okay, but really needing to make some of those changes so that you can embark on a fun, new, exciting journey, okay, that I think my Pisces are going on, all right? So that's what I got for you. Mars also just moved into your eighth house as well, making that more of a thing. Still more changes left to come and where you see your life going, and needing to be patient as you make some of these changes to do something new, but really starting to move in the right direction here to just do something exciting. I like the ninth house. The ninth house is a good house here, so I think you got some fun things going on, Pisces. All right, now your card for the week is the World reversed. This is kind of an interesting card, okay, because the World upright to me indicates completions in some way, endings, also feeling like you've got the world in the palm of your hand, okay, and like you've done everything that you need to do and have everything you need. And I think when it's reversed, feeling like something's missing here. You don't have everything that you need to feel like you've completed something or ended something or put it in the right place. And I think what you need to do this week, tie up any loose ends, okay, get rid of anything that's preventing you from ending one chapter of your life and moving into a new one that is more exciting and that is better. And I think if you can do that, and you can tie up loose ends, and you can let go of the past, okay, so that you can do something new and different, I think you're gonna feel really good. I think you're gonna feel like you're right in the place that you need to be, okay, and like things are starting to fall into place when maybe they haven't beforehand, okay? So that is what I've got for you, Pisces. Thank you so much for watching my horoscope. If you like it, please like it on YouTube, subscribe to my channel, share it with your friends, and I will talk to you later.